George Nsamba, a member of the Uganda Martial Association, took legal action by seeking a court order to prevent the holding of the extraordinary General Assembly. The petitioner aimed to quash the AGM, preventing any postponement of the elections originally slated for 3rd February this year. The presence of the court order did not deter a significant number of FMU delegates from attending. Former FMU President George Kajimu, along with some delegates, proposed transforming the Extraordinary General Assembly into a consultative meeting, a suggestion not widely supported by most attendees. When a vote was conducted to decide whether to proceed with the General Assembly or not, delegates opted for anonymity and the majority voted for the AGM to proceed.
Let us proceed.
The main focus of the extra general assembly was placed on amending the constitution to align it with the current sports law. Additionally, discussion centered around the organization of upcoming elections. Some of the delegates advocated for voting process, while others suggested tasking leaders with the constitutional amendment responsibilities. After a vote was conducted to make a decision, the majority of the delegates unanimously agreed to elect an interim committee to oversee the federation's activities for a duration of 6 months.
2023, as well as runs of current ASL activities, including the sporting calendar, or continue with the old constitutions.
How do we migrate and align ourselves to this new sports act, which is a law? According to my understanding, the old constitution of FMU would not have allowed us to do that, in the sense that the new act tells us to have delegates from 75% of the districts in Uganda, and 50% of them should be 14 delegates. When we look at our house here, we have all our delegates here, but most of them are based here centrally in Kampala. So when there's a possibility you might have elections for 4-year term in February, and you're going to have a lot of issues where you, the press, are going to go back reporting, or so and so has taken the team that has come into court. The losers will be complaining, whoever has lost in that election, and we will have a lot of, it'll be very murky, very muddy, which is not good for our sport. I'm glad that, I put it out with my team to the General Assembly. We asked for a way forward. Today the General Assembly has decided that there will be no elections for a 4-year term. The elections are going to be for an interim, not even elections, it will be an appointment of a team that will be interim. I don't know how many people that will be the ex-com to decide. Those names will be brought here in the AGM on the 3rd of February for ratification. The members of this General Assembly will decide this person deserves to be there, this person does not deserve to be there. Everything is going to be done transparently.